Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. The very first thing that you hear in your ear as a baby, as you enter into this world, is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And I want you to fast forward to the very last moments of your existence on this earth, where your body is in front of the Imam as the Imam is leading your janazah. And the Imam says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Four takbirat that you will hear right before you're placed into the grave, just like it was one takbir that you heard as soon as you came out of your mother's womb. SubhanAllah, our entire lives are between Allahu Akbar and Allahu Akbar. And the Prophet ﷺ's mission was described as wa rabbaka fakabbir, proclaim the greatness of your Lord, wa kabbirhu takbira, and proclaim His limitless greatness. Your entire life is to declare the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to make it apparent on this earth.
Allahu Akbar.
Now, what is encompassed in Allahu Akbar? Allah is the greatest. And Allah is Akbar. Allah is greater than everything. He's greater than what you know of Him. He's greater than what you can say about Him. He's greater than all others. He's greater than all else. He's greater than your praise. He's greater than what you think of yourself. He's greater than your happiness. He's greater than your sadness. He's greater than your pursuits. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. Allah is greater. He is the King of all kings, the most worthy of our attention, the most worthy of our adoration, the most worthy of our praise, and the only one who remains when everything else perishes, and the only one who is worth it, even while other people and things still exist. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no one ever utters La ilaha illallah or Allahu Akbar, except that he is given glad tidings. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, what glad tidings? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the glad tidings of Al-Jannah. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, that the servant's utterance of Allahu Akbar, just saying Allahu Akbar, is better than the world and everything that is contained within it. Now let's think about how embedded it is, even in our acts of worship. When it comes to salah, it's how the prayer is called, it's how we enter into the prayer, it's how we move from position to position, and even at the end, Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, كنت أعرف انقضاء صلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالتكبير. I used to know the end of the prayer of the Prophet ﷺ with Allahu Akbar. And the scholars debated, does that mean that Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma was saying that the Prophet ﷺ, after Taslim, would immediately say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar? Or did he mean that it is the end of the dhikr? And that's the more correct opinion, that even our azkar after salah, our remembrance after salah, the Prophet ﷺ taught us to say Alhamdulillah 33 times, Subhanallah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. And so a person is called with Allahu Akbar, a person starts with Allahu Akbar, a person goes through the salah with Allahu Akbar, and then even the end of your dhikr is Allahu Akbar 34 times. And this is also narrated about the time of sleeping that a person says Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. And by the way, there are different narrations and all of them are authentic. One of them where the Prophet ﷺ said, say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar 10 times after salah each. One of them where the Prophet ﷺ says, say each one of them 33 times and then end off with La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah until the end of the dua. And many of them where the Prophet ﷺ says, say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. So that's salah. What about Hajj? Every single one of the manasik of Hajj, every single one of the rituals of Hajj has takbir embedded within it. As a person is passing around in tawaf, passing around the black stone, Allahu Akbar. As a person goes from each of the jamarat, Allahu Akbar. As a person moves on the day of Eid, Allahu Akbar. So Hajj is embedded within our manasik of Hajj, even the sa'i, subhanAllah, as a person ascends, as-safa, al-marwa, Allahu Akbar. So we see it in salah, we see it in Hajj, and how does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe the end of Ramadan? وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ, that you finish the period of Ramadan and then you declare the greatness of Allah over that which He has guided you to. So it's embedded in our pillars of Islam. And we see it in so many other aspects of our ibadah. When a person sees the hilal, it's the first part of the dua of seeing the hilal, Allahu Akbar. When the Prophet ﷺ saw the lunar eclipse, Allahu Akbar. When Eid comes, as Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates, زَيِّنُوا أَعْيَادَكُمْ بِالتَّكْبِيرِ, that beautify your Eid with as much takbir as possible on the days of Eid. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you sacrifice, إِذَا سَمَّيْتُمْ فَكَبِّرُوا, when you sacrifice an animal, then say Bismillah وَكَبِّرُوا, and say Allahu Akbar. So it's embedded within our ibadat. But outside of that, how should we use this wonderful form of dhikr? And Imam bin Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, takbir is when we humble ourselves to Allah's power, or we seek to summon strength from His power, or we celebrate victory knowing that it only comes from the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you'll find that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say Allahu Akbar as he was ascending a hill. You'll find that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would begin his travel with Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Subhanalladhi sakhara lana hadha, until the end of the dua for travel. So he starts off with takbir before encountering a difficult journey or a difficult climb. You also find that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say takbir, would say Allahu Akbar, at the time of victory or at the time of good news. It's narrated in multiple occasions that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used Allahu Akbar at the time of al-bishara, at the time of receiving glad tidings, or at the time of giving glad tidings. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he once heard a man say, Allahu Akbaru kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. Allah is the greatest. Allahu Akbaru kabira. Allah is truly the greatest. Walhamdulillahi kathira. And praise be to Allah in abundance. Wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. And glory be to Allah in the morning and in the evening. And when the Prophet ﷺ heard that, he turned around and the Prophet ﷺ said, who said that? And they pointed to the man. And the Prophet ﷺ said, عَجِبْتُ لَهَا فُتِحَتْ لَهَا أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ, that I was amazed by that statement. That one statement literally opened the gates of the heavens.